Hi, we're the Spice Girls.
Let's get this party started.
Thank you for your support.
Yes, go for it.
Girl Power.
Erleben Sie die heißeste Band des Jahrzehnts. Steigen Sie mit TV Media und Mediamarkt in die faszinierende Welt der Spice Girls ein. Genießen Sie das topaktuelle Video zur brandheißen CD Forever. Treffen Sie Mel C, Posh, Mel B und Emma zum Smalltalk und hören Sie die 6 besten Songs der heißesten Girlband der Welt. Viel Spaß mit den Spice Girls wünschen Ihnen TV Media und Mediamarkt.
Love is all it was.
Nothing
was so bad that you felt that you had to do to me what she had done to you. Now you prove everything that my friends had told me about you was true. Now it's over and
you
we're through.
You blame me and acting your way. So can you blame me for walking away? What did I do to be treated so bad?
Treated so bad.
Now you have lost me.
And that was the best thing you'd ever had.
I don't know what's going on.
I
know with you, I just keep wasting my time. I can't keep holding on.
Cause I know with you,
I just keep wasting my time.
We've looked at them and said, oh, we want this dress on it or we want that. So this is official stuff that is worth the money and it's quality. Obviously, that's very flattering, but then it's good in a way for children because we're not perfect, you know what I mean? We're not tall, skinny models. We're just normal girls
normal
who get
girls.
Spots, get greasy hair, you know, and that's good for the young teenagers, you know. So it's quite good. It's a good message for, you know, for teenagers. I mean,
and
it's girl power if the girl's in... Playboy are doing it for themselves and they want to, then that's great, that's girl power. But you know, we always feel like you should do it because you want to do it. It's not mainly, or what did you get for Christmas, you know.
Some
I think the
on.
Only thing that happens, you see, when you go out is you get people coming up to you.
For
like
asking
fans.
For an autograph.
But the thing is, at the end of the day, they're the fans that buy your records, and if you haven't got 5 minutes to sign an autograph for them, then that's not very good, really, is it? It's a bit sick. You know, you've got to take time out, and it doesn't affect you. You know, you can still do your shopping. And, but it's down to the public at the end of the day. You know, someone else might come along and take, you know, the limelight. But we're just having fun while we're here now and doing as much as we can. And, you know we're very optimistic but realistic at the end of the day. You never know what's going to happen. When we met Prince Charles, it just happened. We just chatted and it was funny. You know, we never sort of go, oh, I'm going to say this and you can say that. And it's not like that. We just see what happens. You know, you never know. They might not want to talk to us. Do you know what I mean? We just see what happens. It's about the media and we just sort of, it's a parody of us. Some of us are trained as singing and dancing and also a few of us have done acting. And it was just something else that we wanted to explore and have a go at. And, you know, Spice Girls, we like to try everything and it's, you know, just have a laugh.
Failure for us, what is failure? I mean, look what we've done. We have put our music down onto CD. So that's not failure. For the people that like it, then that isn't failure to us because we like it and we have managed to get our music heard, not just to one country but to like 37, 38 different countries. So that's not failure. We've been given an opportunity to be able to release our stuff. Yeah, there's lots of things that we've turned down, lots of things. So the things that we do are all important and it's like a little bit of an adventure that we all go on. It's funny. I like it. And as well, for a pop group, they don't really get that many sponsorships, and we have, and we're thinking, you know, that's breaking down one barrier. Pop groups, go and get yourself a sponsor if you want it, go and get it. Not everything we said does, that's going over the top, not everything. I think we are in a position where we've got to kind of have a responsibility in what you say, but what we say comes from us anyway, so if it does make a headline, we will be proud of it, because it's something that we feel is needed to be said.
We said that right from the beginning, that people wanted to, you know, when we first came out, people need, when something's new, they need to say, oh, that's like that. When we first come out, we'd get, oh, yeah, you're the female version of Take That. I mean, no one says that anymore, you know, but now they need to pigeonhole us into something else. Obviously, we're not, so they pigeonhole something else. They'll always be like that. If we're 60 and we're still going, we'll be like the female Rolling Stones.
I wouldn't do anything. I believe in karma. What goes around comes around, and they'll get there. Well, I got unrecognised for about an hour, and then because I walked all the way around it, and nobody recognised me. But then, after about an hour, they did. I just got in a cab and went to go and have something to eat. I had my army jacket on and trousers, hair out. I think life continues after the Spice Girls.
Life goes on.
Because we'll still be a Spice Girl anywhere.
Obviously,
you can't go back. It's fun because you get to see. Right, what we go through a little bit, and it's quite funny. In fact, it's very funny. Yeah. We talked about this a long time ago, and we always believe that Spice Girls is actually more than a band. That's why we've got sponsorship deals, we're doing commercials. You know, it's like Five Little Girls. We want to have a go at everything, and having a go at doing a movie is just like, wow, we've done it. I mean, obviously, our music is important, and that's a theme tune to the movie, but, you know, it's like anything. You know, we like to try a little bit of everything. So, you know, we do our own things. You know, I think things that you do from yourself are always the best things, because then you've been true to yourself. And if somebody knocks you, at least it's your own fault, your own mistake, nobody else's.
It's sad that, you know, but it's the fact that everybody, well, a lot of people have a price. It would be satisfaction, because if we were to see an ex-boyfriend that had sold a story and you go and slap them in the face,
I've
just got a story for the
them.
Next day. It helps a lot, because obviously, you know, you're seeing a lot more places. Like, we've got a lot of exposure through the sponsorship deals that we have done, you know, publicity that money couldn't buy, which is half of the reason why we've actually done a lot of the sponsorship deals. It's just a shame that there's obviously young children that are being ripped off, getting unofficial merchandising that isn't good quality and could also be dangerous to sort of like our younger fans. And obviously there's nothing you can do. I mean, there is so much stuff out there that is unofficial, it's unbelievable. There's nothing you can do. I wouldn't be in Playboy, but in respect to, you know, a sex symbol thing, you know, we would never dress a certain way to appear sexy.
I can't believe a sex symbol.
We would just dress that way because we want to dress that way, not to appear to anybody else that way.
That's actually
if they think that, then that's great, but that's not the reasons behind the way we dress.
Yeah.
I think that was a typical example of what you just said. You know, how do you feel about everything you say being taken out of context and being written about? I think that's probably what happened with John Lennon. He probably just said it as a joke, and it was totally, you know, I mean, I think that obviously when we're compared to the Beatles, it's very flattering. They're a fantastic band. You know, it's flattering, but a lot of people like to pigeonhole you, and at the end of the day, we just say, you know, something we're into when we're, you know, when we're older in a few years, you know, we'd like to have families. You know, I think we all would. Mm. You know, it's just a natural womanly thing. But we'll always be friends and we'll always support each other. Obviously, though, we think, you know, there should be more girl bands. That's something that we said when we first came out. So it's great. We think it's really healthy. We don't ever really plan anything like that. We just sort of like, bit of spontaneity, go with the flow.
See what happens.
Exactly.
And that's it.
He might want to have a party, mightn't he? Yeah, we met him when we was doing, a TV station in England. Just seemed like a really nice man, and the only people we had in the film were people that we thought they were, you know, the right parts for. We didn't just get people in because they were famous. Well, we've done a few live performances. We did Saturday Night Live in America, and, you know, we've done a few roadshows.
Birmingham,
but this
we've done the MTV
first,
Awards. That was quite big, wasn't it?
But this was the first thing that we've done that was, you know, lots of songs. We did 15 songs, totally live. Choreographed dances, different costumes. It was really exciting for us because performing live is what we like doing the most.
Hi, this is Melanie C, and I just want to say thank you so much for making me number one. Yep, the album's going to be out in November. It's almost finished. A bit of vocaling to do, but it's all written and just to be mixed. It's we're quite excited actually because it is quite different for us. It's still very poppy and loads of fun, but we've been working with some new collaborators, some American producers, Bradley Jerkins and Jamma Millis. So there's a, you know, really big sounds, and it's I suppose it's a little bit more R&B in some areas, and then vocally it's a lot more challenging because we're more confident now singing after we've done a lot of touring and stuff. I think inevitably, you know, that's just the way it is going. I mean, it's still loads of fun, and when we get back together, we are just the same. We're just like really stupid, but we are growing up. You know, there's two mums in the band. And I'm just about to go through the menopause.
Not remembering that.
I would like children one day, but not just yet. But I mean, you know, I don't want them at the moment. I'm just hoping one day I will, because you know what I mean. I think the main difference for me is I am more fulfilled as a solo artist, because you get to tell the story, you get to sing the whole song, you know. Because at the end of the day, my singing. That is just my thing, you know. I love singing, and it's real good fun with the Spice Girls. But only getting to sing, a line in, a line out, or a section is that it can be frustrating as an artist, because I want it in the whole song. I want to take the journey, you know. I mean, I want to take the listener on a journey, and you can't do that when it's all between different people. I think this is the real thing for now. I think Spice Girls was real when I was younger. You know, but now I'm a little bit older and a bit more serious, and I'm going to take this a bit more seriously now. Oh, Flatters! Oh, absolutely, I can't believe anything. I can't believe, you know, Spice Girls. The whole Spice Girls phenomenon, to me, is like, it didn't really happen. You know what I mean? It's crazy, I can't comprehend it, and, you know, I just try to, like, blank it out. It's really early days to say that, you know, because Mel B's album's out this year, Emma's will be out, and Victoria's next year. So, you know, it's early days, and, you know, who's to say? I think, you know, we've all been so successful. But it's the work you put in, isn't it? You know what I mean? I do work very hard. And I've just been, you know, I didn't have a baby, I had an album, so I was quickest off the mark. This really fucking pissed me off, if I'm allowed to say that, because, you know, they can say anything about my, you know, about me, I'm famous, you know, that comes, it's part and parcel of the job. But, you know, Ying's a professional, and it was all lies anyway. We didn't share a room, we didn't share a bed, and even if we did, do you know what I mean? I sleep with girlfriends all the time, do you know what I mean? Oh, that quote's going to be used well. But, and then one day she's seeing Joe, one day she's not. It's just like, fuck off. It's no one's business anyway. It's so infuriating. It's, you know, when Ying's, you know, her family, and there's other people who get hurt in the process, and they're just making a quick buck. They know it's all lies. They've made it all up. They know it's not true.